Okay, so sorry. After one minute, how many fist bumps?
11.
11. So notice how 1 minute lines up with 11, which means that 8 fence posts is how many minutes?
Zero.
So we've got that, like, figure zero.
And if you're paying close attention there.
After 2 minutes, how many fence posts?
Four.
All right, so clearly the minutes are going up by 1, and the number of fence posts are going up by?
3.
We're adding 3. The pattern is 3, okay? So X minutes later, right, how are we going to predict how many fence posts there are? What about X minus 1? Jackson?
Well, since it goes up by 3 fence posts every minute, it'd be 3 times X minutes. And then.
Why X minus 1?
Oh, yeah, X minus 1.
How come?
Because you already have the ones at 1 already. I don't know how to explain it.
Have the 1 already. Kiana, why X minus 1?
Well, it depends on if you're starting from 1 minute.
That's key right there. She says if you're starting from 1 minute,
then you would go minus 1. But because in this situation you're starting from 0 minutes, it wouldn't be minus 1.
You could start from 1. But then you have to, you know, that would just be more work. So I would just say go 3x, no 1. So you say 3x plus 8. What about the person who has 3 times x minus 1? This person clearly, Tiana has laid out, this isn't even what Tiana did. She didn't start from 1, but she recognizes that this person would be starting from 1. So then that means this person would have plus what?
11.
Plus 11. So plus, well, this isn't the plus, it's the plus for this guy. 11 plus 3 times x minus 1, or 3 times x minus 1 plus 11, however you like to have it. If I were to distribute this 3 and simplify it, I would just get 3x plus 8. We could write it this way. We could write it this way. Y equals 3 times x minus 2 plus 14. Why not? So we could do that. But I think there's a test to see if it's like that. You can write your equation like that. So either way, this way, that way, any other way, that if you plug in an x, you get the correct number of fence posts for that minute. We can test them both for minute 3, okay? You know how many we should have in minute 3, right? How many should we have?
17.
We just follow the pattern out. Okay, 3. We put 3 right there. That gives us 3 times 3 minus 1 plus 11. That's 3 times 2 plus 11. 6 plus 11 is 17. Or we use this one. 3 times, just plug in 3 plus 8. 9 plus 8. Both of those formulas work out. And number 4, where we are losing the same amount, not gaining the same amount each time. We did one, actually, it used exactly the same figures. They were reversed, though. They were growing.
Oh.
And I don't think we wrote a formula. We may have written a formula, but I switched it so we were losing some.
I got you. Okay.
Well, what's the pattern?
We're losing six.
We're losing 6. So we're adding on. We're thinking of adding on a bunch of negative sixes, or we're subtracting a bunch of sixes. So we can think of it as starting here at 1, 2, let's see, this is 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Starts at 14, then we're going to subtract
from there, we're always going to subtract off from 14. How much are we going to subtract? Well, we're going to subtract 6 several times. How many times are we going to subtract 6? Once
for figure 2.
Twice for figure 3. How many times for figure 4 are we going to subtract the 6?
3.
3 times. How many times for figure 10 would we subtract
9.
6? 9 times. How many? Here it is for figure X.
13.
X minus 1 sixes would be subtracted. So negative 6 times X minus 1. We can think of it that way. We could also, if we're inclined to back up to figure 0, without drawing it, because we would be here a while as I drew this. How many would be in this figure?
20.
Let's see, we're losing 6 as it goes this way, so we should gain 6. This is 14. We gain 6 from 14. This is going to have exactly 20 blocks. So we can start at figure 1 and come up with this. We can start at figure 0 and come up with y equals. Well, we start with 20. We're going to subtract 6 by x, because now when I go to figure 1, I subtract 6 once. When I go to figure 2, I subtract 6 twice. When I go to figure 3, I subtract 6 1, 2, 3 times. That pattern's going to continue. When I go to figure x, I would subtract 6 x times. Subtract 6 x times. Negative 6 times x. So 20 minus 6x, negative 6x plus 20. If I were to distribute this negative 6 and you can combine like terms, I'd wind up getting 20 minus 6x as well. Okay, let's put everything away except for a single piece of paper. We're going to take a review. Okay, looking and sounding great. Thank you very much. All right, so figure, what we'll call figure 1 and figure 2 and figure 3. The pattern is that we go up by how much?
3.
By 3. Where did those 3 get added on to?
Like the bottom, the
diagonal,
and
the
top.
Okay, top and on the
bottom
side. Okay. So you see this vertical column building, this horizontal and this diagonal row or diagonal.
Just call it the diagonal.
So we add 3 on, add 3 on again, so on, so on, so on. So if we start at figure 1, we're going to add 3 onto that. Once to get to figure 2, twice to get to figure 3. How many times to get to figure 7?
6.
If I added 3 14 times, which figure would I be on?
15.
Right, we're going the other way. We get to go 14 down the row. We're at 15.
That's only if you start at figure 1.
It is if you start at figure 1. If I started at figure 3 and I went 14 down the line, which figure would I be at?
Figure 17.
17, yeah. Figure 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. If I go 14 down that way, I would get figure 17. Right. So if we start at figure 1, which is reasonable to do, start at figure 1, right, which actually has 4 blocks, and we start adding on from there, we would be increasing, right? We're adding because it's getting bigger. There's more blocks every figure. So we're adding on how much?
3,
right? But not just, you can't just add 3 once, that would just get me to figure 2. If I added on twice, that'd get me to figure, which figure would that get me? 3. If I added it on 3 times, that'd get me to figure
4.
Yes. If I added it on
X amount of times.
37 times, which figure would I be at?
36.
36, I'd be at 38. If I added it on x times, which figure would I be at?
X.
X
plus 1.
I would be at x plus 1.
Boom.
If I added on x minus 1 times, which figure am I at?
X.
Figure X.
I'm always at 1 more, right?
Figure 1.
Added on 14 times, I'm at figure 15. Added on 27 times, I'm at figure
28.
If I added on x minus 1 times,
it
would be at 1 past that. Right? 1 past x minus 1 would be x.
Oh.
God,
so
So but instead of adding on 3 a bunch of times, right, that's a perfect job for multiplication. 3 times x minus 1.
Plus 1? Yeah.
If I want to get down to figure x, how many times will I add on 3? X minus 1 times.
Yeah.
Right? And again, the examples, 3 more examples once again. If this were figure 17, I would have to add on how many times?
18.
Which figure is this?
17.
How many times would I add on a 3?
16 times.
X amount of times.
X minus 1 times.
Okay. So I said, I think I said 17. Okay, I've lost track by now.
So then you go
to figure 17, add 16. If I'm going out to figure 53, I'd have to add on how many 3s?
52
of them. If I go out to figure x, I'd have to add on 1 less than that. Because x minus 1. Tiana? Figure 0, Dalton, has it passed? Oh, okay. So starting at figure 0, let's move everything down a bit. Grab everything here. Down. We're back up to figure 0. Take away this vertical column, this horizontal, this diagonal. We're left with one of them. Figure 0 has one block. So we can start with that one block and now add on 3 times x instead of x minus 1 because to go from figure 0 to figure 3 takes 3 steps. To go from figure 0 to figure 18 takes 18 steps. To go from figure 0 to figure x takes that many steps, x steps. Bug class. It's not etymology class. Entomology class.
What's
math
that?
Class.
What is
study
it?
Of bugs.
Someone's just
we're talking about the bugs in your
mouth. Okay. I'm bringing it in. Okay, so this kid named David is standing in the gym as people come in for a basketball game, starts a stopwatch. Okay, notice it does not say how many people are there right then, it just starts it. After 1 minute, then he notices that there are 14. After 2 minutes, there are 22. And at 3 minutes, there are 30 people sitting in the stand. We can organize this information with X minutes and Y people. We don't know how many there were at the very beginning, but we do know once 1 minute has gone by, how many people are there?
14.
And 2.
22.
And 3. And
30.
So do we have a pattern here?
Yeah, it was up by 8.
By 8. Still going up by 8?
Yeah.
Pretty important. As we learned yesterday, if we're going to stay. Yes, you've got to go up by the same amount every time, otherwise you have a different kind of function. So it goes up by 8 every time. So after, here, let's make a prediction about minute 13. How many people are going to be there at minute 13?
13 minus 1 times 8 plus 14.
So she's starting with 14, right? Starting with 14, and she's adding on 8 and 8 and 8 and 8 and 8. How many times are you going to add on 8 to get to the 13th?
12.
Minute 12. 8 times 12, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. 12 would be at 13. So 14 plus the extra 8 times 12 people that are going to show up between minute 1 and minute 13. 14 plus 8 times 12, which is 96. So 110 people that should should be at minute 13, right? Unless my mental math is off, which is very, very possible. Mental math is not right. Okay? Mental arithmetic. Not my strong suit. We'll assume that when you are a math teacher, you're a human calculator, which is not the case. Okay? I understand math concepts as a human that I can multiply numbers and find 15% of the restaurant bill in my head. But anyone ever done that? History of mankind, I'm sure someone did.
Yeah.
Right away. But we are wondering, after, you know, a vague X minutes, right, how do we predict how many people are there? Well, we know we always start with 14 people. We're going to be adding on 8 people every minute. How many minutes are going to go by between 1 minute and X minutes?
X minus 1
minutes. This was a Jasper from period 5. He was thinking of it as those amounts of time, and that's a good way to think of it. If you're at minute 1 and you go to minute 13, it's going to take 12 minutes to get there. If you're going from minute 1 to minute X, it's going to be one less minute than that. So X minus 1 minutes are going to pass between minute 1 and minute X. Tiano's first. Question? Comment?
Comment. I said it from minute 0, just when he starts the stopwatch.
So we can imply from this pattern that there were likely how many people when he started the stopwatch?
6
people. We're back up to minute 0, just going to squeeze that in there. 0 and 6 people were there, which makes us have y equals. We'll start at 6. And then how many minutes will pass from 0 to 13? 13 minutes. How many minutes will pass from 0 minutes to X minutes?
X.
X minutes. So, 8X.
Josh was the one with the red hair, right?
That's right.
You're like,
you're
friends.
I'm glad you didn't forget to ask that question.
What's your
reference? Hold on
to
it. Okay. Any questions about that? Okay, so we spent a long time, and I think it's been time well spent, looking at patterns where the figure number, the number of minutes, the number of days, the number of hours, whatever, that goes by, always by one. It just goes by steadily, one by one by one. Figure 1, figure 2, figure 3, minute 0, minute 1, minute 2. Okay? And we've seen the figures get bigger. We've seen them get smaller. All right? So now let's see how we do with something like this following challenge, I guess. Terribly challenging, but it is something a little different. So rather than make you look at figures and count the number of the blocks and do all that kind of stuff, let's try and graduate to something a little more abstract, where we have a table, okay, and we're just working off the table. So you can make this anything you want. It can be figure 1, it can be minute 1, it can be day 1, hour 1, whatever you want it to be. It does not matter. Because
they're just
numbers. So, whichever of those analogies rings true to you more, just make it that. If it was minutes and fence posts, make it minutes and fence posts, unless I tell you otherwise. If it's figures and numbers of blocks, make it that. Okay. So let's say, for unity's sake, I'll call it figure 1, has 7 blocks. Now figure 4. 16. How many are in figure 8? See if we can figure that out. So if from figure 1 to figure 4 we're steadily climbing up little by little, every figure. Okay? If we continue the same pattern up to figure 8 or minute 8 or whatever, we should be at 28.
Yeah.
I got you.
Some of you have, that was the trick answer, like the answer that if, so here's what you're thinking, from 1 to 4, you see an increase of 9, okay, we go up 4, so you're thinking another 9, but from 1 to 4, how many steps is that?
Three.
And from 4 to 8, how many steps is that?
4.
So it didn't go up the same. But then it kind of, it's like a visual, like an optical illusion almost.
All right, what's our homework?
Hold on. Here's the homework. Very similar. Figure 1 or minute 1, we have 8. Figure 5 is 24. Figure 26. How many have
it? Whoa.
That's it. That's your homework. Have a good day.